Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, and today we're going to go over 5 tips for success on your medical rounds. Basically, what you need to do as a medical student to show that not only you have the knowledge, but you're good at what you do. So let's get started by going over each tip. So number one, know your patient. It's really important you know all the details about your patient. A lot of times we get a history and physical from the night team, and they've written out a history that they've collected. Really, it's really important you gather your own history in your own words. One, it makes it easier to memorize and repeat, so it looks really good when you're just saying stuff off the top of your head and not looking at a paper. And two, you get accurate data. In addition, know the basics about the patient. So that includes their medical history, when they were diagnosed with certain diseases, includes their surgical history, what surgery they've had, and when was the most recent surgery. It also includes a social history. So know, do they drink? Do they smoke? Or do they work? Where do they work? And then kind of pertinent medications that relate to their case. Number two, what's really important is kind of anticipate the needs of your team. So your residents and your attending. So if you think hospital records are needed, go out and try to get those outside hospital records, or at least get consent for hospital records. So that way you're ready, you're on rounds, you already have a plan, they already know you're gonna get these records for them, and they will really appreciate that. In addition to getting outside hospital records, also make sure you have an updated med list on your patient, because it's really important that your team is working with the most up-to-date information. Third and most important key point, which I really stress, is create a really strong assessment and plan, because this is where you demonstrate your knowledge and your ability to take a history and turn it into an actual plan for the patient. And this will demonstrate if you're really gonna be a good doctor. So what you wanna do to create a good an assessment and plan is identify all the problems the patient has. I don't care if it's a minor headache to pneumonia. You wanna identify from the minor to the major problems the patient has. And then create a strong plan. What are you gonna do for those problems? What are you gonna do for that cough? What are you gonna do for that shortness of breath? This brings me to key point number 4. Read about your patients. If your patient has diabetes, if your patient has COPD, make sure you've read up about how to diagnose and treat these disorders. Really, it's important for you to know so you can present well, but as we all know, as medical students, we always get that Q&A on rounds, otherwise known as pimping, and to really shine during these pimping sessions, you really need to know about what is affecting your patient. 2, you can also cite some articles. So if your patient has diabetes, you can cite the NICE sugar trial. Or if it has sepsis, talk about the surviving sepsis campaign. Now, it's not a must, but it makes you look good, and it demonstrates that you're reading up on your patients. Final and 5th key point is make sure you're part of the team, you're a team member. So if there's another medical student with you and they're having trouble, you helping them out will look really good to you, both the attending and the resident. So the main point here is just really don't be a gunner, don't try to put down your other medical students, and don't try to outcompete or outshine your residents. Just be a part of the team, and that's really important. In addition to being a team member, it's really important that you incorporate the advice of your senior residents and attending. When you don't, it really looks bad upon you because all they're really doing is trying to make you a better doctor. So I hope you enjoyed these tips, and I hope they really help you out in your internal medicine rounds. If you like this video, make sure to share this with your friends on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool. Make sure to give this video a like. If you have any comments or suggestions for future videos or about this video, place them down below. And most importantly, subscribe. This is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, and I'll see you next time.